Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. This is Awoka from Learn to Code. In this video, we'll see how to create a digital clock by using Python programming language. This is a very simple Python project like other previous projects we see in this YouTube channel. At the end of this Python project, you can create a very simple and attractive digital clock by writing sublime of codes in Python. Okay, for more understanding, now I will show you what this digital clock looks like. For that, I run this Python code and as you see, this is a digital clock and it shows the current time and it updates every second. So today's video task is creating these types of digital clock by using Python programming language. Okay, now we can start coding to create your own digital clock. By the way, if you are new to my channel, my name is Awoka from Learn to Code. In this YouTube channel, I will upload so many programming videos related to different Python projects, data science, machine learning, deep learning, computer vision, and also blockchain tutorials. If you want to get those contents from me, please subscribe my channel and turn on the bell icon to get a notification when I upload a new video. Okay, when we come to this video, this is a very simple Python project which helps you to create a very simple digital clock. Now we can start coding this project. For that, I use PyCharm Python IDE. You can also use this Python IDE or you can use your own favorite Python IDE. For me, PyCharm is the best Python IDE for these types of Python automation projects. For that, I open PyCharm and create a new Python file. As you see, this is a blank Python file which is ready to write Python code. After that, we need to import important Python modules. For this project, we need user interface module and also the time module for displaying the current time. For that, first I import tkinter Python module. This tkinter Python module helps us to create a pop-up display window for showing our digital clock. Tkinter is one of the Python user interface modules, so I wanted to use this tkinter Python module for this project. So I write from tkinter import star. This star is used to import everything from this tkinter module. So from tkinter module, I import everything. Okay, now we import this Python module. The next important Python module we need to create this digital clock is time module. This time module is used to display your computer time in this program. So we need to import this Python module. For that, I write from time import strf time. This strf time is a function in the time module and it is used to display the operating system time. Okay, we finished importing important Python modules. The next important point is creating a pop-up window to display time by using tkinter window. For that, I create an object by writing tk class from the tkinter module. So I write root equals tk like this. Root equals tk. This program creates a tkinter window to display a time. After that, we need to give the title for our window. For that, I write root dot title. Root is an object. So root dot title. And inside this parenthesis, you can give your title name. For this program, I give the title digital clock. You can give any name you want to give. For this, I write like this. Root dot title and I give the name digital clock. This code helps us to give the title for our project. Okay, after that we need to style and label our window. For that I write label equals label and inside this parenthesis I pass root. Root, font, background color and foreground color. You can give any font type, font size, and also you can give any color for the background color and foreground color. So for this Python project, I give the font equals Arial inside double quotes and I will give size of 160 the font size and I give also bold. After that, I will put comma and I will give the background color. For that, I write BG. BG means a background color equals. And I want to give the background color black. For that, I write black like this. After that, I will put comma and give the foreground color. So for the foreground color, I write fg equals, and fg means a foreground color, so I write white. I wanted to give white for the foreground color like this. Okay, this is the label for the digital clock, and at the end I wanted to pack this label. For that, I write dot pack like this, and inside this pack parenthesis I write anchor equals center comma fill equals both and expand equals one. After you put dot, you can write pack, and inside the parenthesis anchor equals center fill equals both and expand equals one like this. Or you can write label dot pack, and inside this pack parenthesis you can write like this: label dot pack and anchor equals center fill equals both and expand equals one by separating a comma from one another. By the way, this packing method in tkinter packs widgets to rows and columns for labeling positions, so you can use this packing method. Okay, now we finish the styling and labeling of our window. After that, we move to the next step, which is creating a function to display time on the label. So, as we know, to create a function in Python, we use a div keyword. For that, I write div type. This time is a function name. You can give any name you want to give for the function name you want to give. For this function name, I give the time for simplicity. After that, inside this time function, I create a variable string. String equals strf time, like this. String equals strf time. And inside this parenthesis, I write hour, minute, and second. And at the end, I put p for displaying am and pm. This strf time is a function inside the time Python module. So using this function, we can display time on the hour label. So after that, I write label.config. And inside this, I write text equals string. Label.config and text equals string, like this. Label.config, and inside that parenthesis, you can write text equals string. String is a variable we created before. So this config function helps us to display the string variables on the label window. Okay, next I write label.after, and inside this 1000 comma time, 1000 comma time, like this. Label.after, inside the parenthesis 1000 comma time. This program helps us to update every 1000 microseconds, that means every seconds. Okay, now we finish our program. The next is calling this function and run it. As we know, to call any function in Python, we need to write a function name. So to call this function, I write this function name. For that, I write time like this. And at the end, I write root.mainloop. Root.mainloop. This root.mainloop is used for opening and controlling our tkinter window. So this root.main for loop is also important. Okay, now I run this Python program and see what it looks like. As you see, this program works. It shows our computer time like this. You can also change the font or the label or colors for styling this window. Okay, this is all about today's video. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Thanks again.